which is a really moody wreck to dive on.
She sits nicely on her hull. Really flat sandy bed around.
She's got a lot of her original appeal, her conning tower still on. Her fins are still out. We begin our descent from the surface. We head down a line which is shotted to the side of us. We just drop a weight off one of her sides.
We've been very lucky with the conditions.
From about 15 meters, you could start to make out a shape. At 25, you could clearly see there was something underneath you. By the time we got to 40, you clearly knew that you were on a beautiful big submarine. When you're on it, you get a real feeling that you're on a piece of history. And of course, she is a gigantic piece of history.
What struck me was it's so much bigger than I remembered it. The girth of it, the size of the conning tower, the propellers. I kept seeing the footage in my head as I was looking at the conning tower. Imagine seeing all these people just, you know, inside there. And remembering the history of when it was depth charged and it plunged to the bottom. And it must have at some point been lying on the bottom like it is now, full of people trying like mad to work out how to get back to the surface.